clear, sir, the way this house has been conducting itself today, certain of us, we have made the issue extremely light and extremely, I would say,
partisan
and political. This is not a partisan or political issue. We should deal with it in a much more serious tone, and we should stop from blaming the BJP or the Congress or any individual chief minister or any individual party as such. We are all contributing to this problem by our present behavior. One of the major reasons, sir, I have realized in my constituency is the way the Maoists are dealing with justice. Sir, if you go to our police stations, whether it is in Jharkhand or Orissa or Uttar Pradesh or Delhi or anywhere, the way the police behaves and the delay in our judicial system, that is alienating the poor and the backward. Sir, what the Maoists did or have been doing is instant justice. In my constituency, in one of the blocks, a person appeared for an RPF, Railway Protection Force job. He got it. And before he was taken in and recruited and taken for training to Mughal Sarai, he got married. 3 months later, about 95 days later, he left the village. His wife was pregnant when he left the village. Then he went and joined the forces, and for 2 years he never came back to the village. 2 years later, when he heard that his father has kicked the bucket, has died, the man wanted to come back, and he being the eldest son of the family wanted to sell off the land. At that moment, this lady, she appealed to the Maoists, and the Maoists came into the village, held a village panchayat, and they said, we are not going to touch this RPF man, but anybody who buys this land will not survive one single day. And the man was compelled to write all his belongings, all his land, all his holdings in his wife's name. So this kind of very basic, crude justice system that they have started implementing has endeared them to the public, to the poor and to the underprivileged.
Yes.
So if we think that all problems can be solved with the gun, then of course we will have one statement saying intellectual arrogance, the other statement saying something else, and the whole country will be in a mess.
Okay, please wind up.
Sir. Sir, another issue I would like to mention is that reports, news reports said that most of the 76 CRPF men lost part of their limbs or were badly wounded and were left lying in the fields for 7 to 8 hours bleeding to death, and not a single helicopter could go there. Unfortunately, and with due respect to all departed souls, when a VIP's helicopter went missing, we could send 8 helicopters within 2 hours. But when our soldiers were dying in the fields, we could not send even 2 helicopters in 8 hours.
Yes, Sadagat,
so this
please.
Is something where we have to go above petty politics, and we have to
get our priorities right.
Get our priorities right. Sir, yes. The US, during the declared period of war in Iraq, they did not lose 76 men. But we lost 76 plus 10, which was a day earlier in Orissa, 86 men in a period of 48 hours.
Yes, please.
So the other major issue that irks all of us is that the Home Minister said that this is war, and the newspapers reported this.
War. Government of India has never used the word enemy. It is they in their literature who use the word war, who use the word enemy. And I said, we have never used the word war. We have never used the word enemy. Please don't misquote.
Thank you. Thank you for the clarification. I'm sorry.
Yes, Tathagat, please take your seat. Now,
sir,
there are 13 more speakers. Please cooperate. Please.
Sir, if they initially... Sir, initially, people thought that this is a careless minister's remarks. But since the minister has clarified it, I am very happy that it is not a careless
yes.
minister's words, but it is the whole government's
yes.
stand that we have to fight the menace. Here I would, sir, I will conclude with a couple of suggestions. I would suggest that better living conditions should be created for our forces. More important is involve local police in leadership situations. Local IPS officers must lead aggressions wherever you are going to fight the Maoist. You must have local police officers and especially IPS officers leading the aggression. Locals have been alienated. Sir, you have fought elections, we have fought elections. You know that when a situation is created in a village that a majority is voting you, the rest of the people also fall in line. Sir, in those areas, the impression has been created that the government is falling back. The government is incapable of fighting these forces, the Maoist forces. So it is very necessary to win over the locals with whatever. But I do not think that electricity, water or roads at this stage can actually win over the locals. So the government has to think of other motives, other works, other initiatives which can win over the confidence which has been lost from the government. And one very important thing is, sir, in these areas there are no good road networks. Most of these areas, even in my constituency where there are Maoist activities, PMGSY work is not being implemented because there are no contractors. And a part of the directive says that it cannot be done by the government directly.
Yes.
So building roads, connectivity is a very essential means to fight this menace. And one reason, one example, sir, you would have noticed.
Please.
Yes, sir, I'm coming. This could be my last minute. Not of my life, but of my speech. Sir, one example you would have seen, sir, is that Maoists always blow up your mobile towers. That is because primarily they are opposed to any kind of connectivity, and also they fear if their cadres use the mobile phones, they can always be tapped and located by government agencies. So connectivity is something that they are very, very seriously working at destroying.
Yes.
And I think the government should also take steps to ensure that connectivity is improved in these areas. And again, at the end, I would like to say that we support the government in this initiative to fight against these forces. I do not know what his party thinks or what his other colleagues consider him, but we can assure that from Orissa, from the Biju Janata Dal, we wholeheartedly, completely support him and his activities, and I hope the Lord Almighty gives him the courage and the strength to stand up for the truth and for the victory of this of the government against these undesirable elements. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Before I call upon the next speaker, I would request all the honorable members.